Good morning, everyone. I am Sarita, Assistant Professor in the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering from Holy Grace Academy of Engineering, Mala. Today, I am going to discuss a topic called frequency modulation. So, in the last session, we have discussed what is modulation, what is amplitude modulation. So, now we'll see what is frequency modulation. FM. So, as already told, modulation is the process of changing the characteristics of a carrier wave, right? So, here, since it is a frequency modulation, we are going to change the frequency of the carrier wave with respect to the message signal. So, changing frequency of carrier wave with respect to the message signal. Okay, let's take a waveform or a mathematical representation of a waveform A sine omega ct plus theta. So here A is an amplitude, omega c is a frequency, and theta is a phase. So this one is a frequency and this is phase. Okay, we can mark this entire term as phi. Yeah, so phi is omega ct plus theta. Since it is a frequency modulation, we are just going to change only the frequency and making this phase as a constant. So I'm marking it as theta now. It is just to denote it is a constant. So when we varying the frequency, there will be a change in the angle phi. Okay, so let's take when t equal to 0, this phi, I'm representing it as phi naught. Phi naught will be equal to, this term becomes 0, so 0 plus theta naught is theta naught. Okay, now I'm changing and taking another instant when t equal to t1, then phi 1 will be equal to omega c1 t1 plus theta naught. Same way when t equal to t2, then theta 2 will be equal to omega c2 t2 plus theta naught, etc. So from this equations, we came to know that at a particular instant, the total angle is only dependent on the variation of the frequency at that instant. Clear? So if you want to calculate the angle phi at a particular instant, you have to take the frequency only because this phase is constant. So in general, we can write as phi can be written as integral 0 to t. I'm taking a period from 0 to t, omega I dt. Clear? So by taking the instantaneous change in the frequency, we can find the phi using this formula. So to find the total angle, you can take an instantaneous angular frequency and just integrate it from 0 to t. So omegas are angular frequency. So what is the formula for omega I? It is an angular frequency. So we can write it as 2 pi fi. So by multiplying 2 pi with the frequency, we can get the angular frequency. Clear? Now we get omega I equal to 2 pi fi. So now we need to find what is fi, that is instantaneous frequency of a modulated wave. Clear? So I have taken A sine omega ct plus theta as a wave which we got after modulation. Okay, EFM. And then I just mark this term, the entire term as phi. So you can rewrite it as EFM is equal to A sine phi. Then I have found the formula for phi, which is nothing but integral 0 to t omega I dt. So omega I is the angular frequency, which is nothing but 2 pi into fi. Now we need to find the instantaneous frequency of a frequency modulated signal. So what will be the instantaneous frequency of a modulated signal? In carrier modulation, or sorry, in frequency modulation, the frequency of the carrier wave is varying according to the message signal. Okay, as we seen in the AM, we have drawn a message signal with a peak amplitude of EM, and we have drawn a carrier signal with a peak amplitude of EC, and this is the signal which we got after the frequency modulation. So when you see the signal, the amplitude is constant, frequency is varying. At particular instant of time, the frequency is getting bunched. Okay, so where it will get bunched? During the positive half cycle, the frequency is increased. During the negative half cycle, the frequency will be decreased. So from the graph itself, it is clear that the frequency of the carrier wave is changing according to the message signal. Because during positive cycle, it gets increased. During negative cycle, it will get decreased. So at a particular instant, the frequency of the modulated wave is purely dependent on the message signal. Clear? So we can write the instantaneous frequency as fc plus k into m of t. Okay, where k is the frequency deviation constant. Its unit is hertz per volt. M of t, as we all know, it is a message signal. I am taking as a sine form. M of t is Em sine omega mt. So instantaneous frequency, this Fi is instantaneous frequency of modulated signal. So instantaneous frequency of the modulated signal is completely dependent on the amplitude of the message signal, so that we can write it as Fi is equal to Fc plus K into M of t. So you can substitute this M of t here. So Fi is equal to Fc plus K into Em sine omega mt. Okay, so we found the formula for Fi. So using this Fi, we can find the formula for omega I, that is angular frequency. So omega I becomes 2 pi into Fc plus K into Em sine omega mt. Okay, now we know the formula for omega I. Just substitute omega I and find out the value for phi. It is a total angle of this modulated wave. Okay. Now I am going to substitute. So phi is equal to integral 0 to t 2 pi into Fc plus K into Em sine omega mt dt. Okay, so you have to separately integrate these two terms. So after integration, we will be getting phi equal to 2 pi fc into t. Plus the second term will be 2 pi km. This 2 pi km is a constant, so we don't need to integrate it. What is integration of sine omega mt? It is minus cos omega mt divided by omega m. Okay, now in the second term you have k into em. This k into em can be called as frequency deviation. Frequency deviation del f. So what is frequency deviation? It is the variation of frequency of modulated wave from the frequency of carrier wave. So So how much variation has occurred in the modulated signal compared to the frequency of the carrier wave? That is known as frequency deviation, which is denoted as del f. So now you can replace KEM with del f, as well as we can write omega m as 2 pi fm. Okay, so you substitute it. So phi is equal to 2 pi fct plus 2 pi. So instead of k into em, I am writing it as del f, frequency deviation, divided by omega is 2 pi fm into minus cos omega m. Okay, now you can cancel this 2 pi and 2 pi. So the equation, final equation becomes 2 pi fct minus del f by fm cos omega mt. Okay, so here we got a term called del f by fm. This is known as modulation index of frequency modulation. So this del fm by fm is modulation index. I'm marking it as mf. So now I'm going to substitute this mf here. So this phi becomes 2 pi fct minus, so instead of del f by fm, I'm going to write mf, that is modulation index, mf sin omega mt. Okay, sorry, cos omega mt. So this is the formula we got for the phi. Now you can substitute this phi in this equation EFM. So what will be the equation? EFM is equal to A into sin of 2 pi fct minus mf cos omega mt. So this is a final formula for the modulated wave, that is frequency modulated wave. So instead of sine, you can take cosine wave also. So if you are taking cosine wave, only one difference is here, instead of sine you will be getting a cos, and instead of cos you will be getting a sine. Okay, so either way you can derive this equation. So that's all about frequency modulation. Okay, so last session we have seen what is amplitude modulation. In this session we have seen what is frequency modulation. Now we are going to compare some parameters of amplitude and frequency modulation. So, a comparison between AM and FM. The first thing is, in AM, the frequency range is much lesser when compared to FM. So what is frequency range? It is a bandwidth. So here the bandwidth is less, and here the bandwidth is high compared to AM. Okay? And AM circuits are less complex, so it is less expensive. But compared to AM, FM is a bit more complex, so it is more expensive. Okay, and another thing is AM or amplitude modulation is not that much immune to the noise, but in FM it is highly immune to the noise, or it can reject the noise. So it is not, or you can say that immunity is less. Here noise can be rejected, so highly immune to the noise. And the last is, if the signal is coming in a different path simultaneously, there may be some, you know, phase changes occur in AM signal. That is, fading is possible in AM signal, but in FM that fading is negligibly small. So the last point is here, fading is high. That is, signals may arrive in or out of phase by different path. Here the fading is negligibly small. So these are the advantages as well as some disadvantages of FM and AM. Okay, so that's all about amplitude modulation, frequency modulation. So now we have gone through different techniques, that is modulation techniques. Now we'll see what are the advantages of a modulation. So what are the advantages? Why we are going for modulation? Basically for reducing the antenna size, right? So the first advantage of modulation. The first advantage is we can, antenna size can be reduced. Okay, antenna size can be reduced. And the second advantage is energy of the signal is high. Energy of the signal is high, so it will have a high reception quality. So therefore, high reception quality. And another advantage is we can increase the range of communication because we are using FM, right? In FM, bandwidth is high. So using modulation, we can increase communication range. And multiplexing is also possible in FM. Modulation. So multiplexing is possible. So these are the main advantages of a modulation. One is antenna size can be reduced and reception quality is high since the energy of the signal is much higher, and we can increase the communication range as well as multiplexing is possible. So that's all about frequency modulation. I hope you all are clear with all the topics we have discussed. Thank you.